2021.
Hope you are written. The students, in this chapter, in the last class, we were focusing on different laws of motion. Among them, the first two were over, right? Total three laws of motion are there. What do you call the first law?
Inertia.
Law of momentum. Third law?
Reaction.
Still, it is to be discussed with respect to first law, that is law of inertia. According to this law, we'll give the statement like this: every body continues in its same state of rest or of uniform motion unless it is compelled by an external unbalanced force. Right? Then we also know that mass is the measure of inertia. That is the relationship between mass and inertia. And SI unit of mass is kilogram. What is the SI unit of inertia?
Kg.
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 Is also kilogram. What do you call the tendency of a body which resists or opposes the change in state of rest?
Inertia.
The change in state of uniform motion.
Inertia of motion.
It is inertia of motion, which opposes the change in the direction of motion.
Inertia of motion.
Inertia of direction. So these are the three important types of inertia. Inertia of rest, inertia of motion, inertia of direction. A passenger who is sitting in an unmoving bus, when the bus starts suddenly, what happens? Whether he leans forward or
backward.
It is due to which type of inertia?
Inertia of rest.
Some number of carom coins are to be arranged in the cylindrical shape, and you will hit that with a striker with a great force. You will observe that the coin which is at the bottom get removed, and the remaining will be in the same state. It is due
inertia
to
inertia of rest.
Inertia of rest.
It is due to inertia of rest. You are in the moving bus. When the bus stops suddenly, what happens? Whether you lean forward or backward?
Forward.
Reason?
Inertia of motion.
Due to inertia of motion. When you are in the bus, when the bus takes the turn sharply towards left side,
we move
right side. What is the reason for this?
Inertia of direction.
And we have different physical quantities, and these can be measured. But how do you go for measuring the motion of the body? It is by using a physical quantity called momentum. The meaning of momentum is, it is the quantity of motion possessed by a body. Quantity of motion possessed by a body is called momentum. What is the mathematical definition for momentum? Yes, Rachid. Yeah. It is the product of mass and velocity. Please do remember this. The product of mass and velocity is called momentum. Lekha, what is the formula used to find out the momentum? Yes, it is
P is equal
to M into V. Then Chandana, how do you write initial momentum? It is MU, final momentum. MV, change in momentum. MV minus MU, the rate of change of momentum.
MV minus MU by E.
What is the rate of change of momentum? It is nothing but force, right? And how do you write this? How can it be written?
M-A.
M into A.
Here M is common, remaining B minus U by T, where B minus U by T is acceleration. A. Therefore, it is M-A, right? And this M-A is nothing but force. And we write the formula used to find out force as F is equal to M into A. I have already given you the detailed steps, the required steps while deriving the formula to find out force, or while deriving the equation F equal to M into A. Now, what is the unit of force?
Newton.
Newton.
Newton. Then, what is the derived unit?
Kg
meter per second.
Meter per second. And we can also write it as 1 Newton is equal to 1 kg meter, 1 kilogram meter per second. Under what condition, or when do you say the force acting on a body is 1 Newton?
An object 1 kg and 1 meter per second accelerates 1 meter per second.
Very good. If a body of mass 1 kg, accelerates 1 meter per second square due to the application of force, then the force is said to be 1 newton. And we also know that F is equal to M into A is the mathematical expression for Newton's second law of motion, which is also known as
law of momentum.
Momentum. So, how do you state Newton's second law of motion? Nalpet. It states that
the rate of change of
momentum of a body, the applied unbalanced force, and the change takes place in the direction of force of light, right? Then after all this, even we solved some of the problems on force as well as momentum. I think most of the types of problems are over. And even we have discussed regarding reasoning questions with respect to momentum as well. That is, when a cricket player, when he is catching the ball, he lowers his hand. Why?
To reduce the force.
Momentum of the ball. Nothing but the quantity of motion possessed by the moving ball. To reduce its effect, he'll go for lowering his hand. By lowering his hand,
time increases.
He will increase the time. As the time increases, rate of change of momentum
decreases.
Then the force exerted by the body also
decreases.
As a result of it, its effect gets reduced, right? Okay. So this much was discussed in the last class. Now we are moving to the next part of this chapter. Before going to this part, let me give you some of the illustrations with respect to this concept. Illustration means? Illustration separate.
Drawing. Example. Example.
Example with figure. Examples with figure. Okay. Very simple situation that we come across in our day-to-day life. And even we'll also hear many times. Assume that here is one of the vehicles. And here is another vehicle. Assume that both are moving in the same direction, in the same line. Both are moving in the same direction and same line. And it is the first vehicle, I call it as first car. It is moving with some velocity, I call it as V1. And this is the second car. It is moving with a velocity v2. Please do remember, both the cars are moving in the same direction and in the same line. They are not changing their line. Could you tell what happens when v1 increases v2? That means when the velocity of first car increases, yeah, it will be more than the velocity of second car.
It collide with second car.
After some time, they collide with each other. An accident takes place, right? When the accident takes place, whether the velocity of both the cars will be same or different, or one car increases, another car decreases, or one first car decreases, another car increases. I've given you four options.
Decreases first car, decreases speed.
Whether both the cars move with the same speed or they move with a different speed.
Different speed.
Obviously, when they collide with each other, their speed decreases.
Because of the collision.
Because of dashing. Damage. Okay. Okay. Of course, the common word. When they collide with each other, then first car will exert the force on second car. If it exerts the force on the second car only, then both would have moved with a greater speed. But here, at the same time, second car will also exert the force on first car. As the force exerted is from both the sides, that is both the sides, and that force is in the opposite to the direction of the motion, hence the speed of both decreases. Right? Eradu kuda decrease agutte. Did you all understand? Here, the force exerted by the first car on the second car, it is called action force on the current. Similarly, at the same time, the force exerted by the second
reaction
car,
reaction force.
The first car, it is called reaction force. Followed, and then I'll take another situation. Look here. That situation is launching of rocket. This is the front portion of the rocket. What do you call the front portion? The near of the cone.
Cylinder.
This is
top.
Payload, where the satellite which is to be launched is to be placed in the front portion. And here, this is fuel tank. Here is engine. And this is the place from which exhaust gas will come out, or burnt gas will come out. During the launching of rocket, you can notice that the fuel gets burnt and it will come out with a greater force, and this will be the it will be this force will be acting towards the ground, and the force with which the exhaust gas will be coming out from the rocket, with the same force the rocket ascends. You are understanding here?
Yes, sir.
The force exerted by the exhaust gas, which is acting towards the ground, it is called action force. Then the force with which the rocket ascends, rocket
reaction force.
Reaction force.
Please do remember here, whatever the amount of force, action force will be there with the and the reaction force magnitude will be same. Both are equal, but they'll be acting in the opposite direction. Now, let me go for taking the third situation. In this third situation, let us take an example of a man walking on the floor. Yes. Please come in. A man walking on the floor. When we are walking, obviously, we push the ground, right? Okay. This is the force exerted by man from his foot to the ground. Whatever the amount of force with which he exerts the force on the ground, with the same amount of force, he'll be moving ahead. Got it? So here, the force exerted by the man on the ground, it is action force.
Action.
Action force.
And the force
reaction
force forward.
Reaction
force.
Reaction.
So these are the forces which are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. And this was, again, this law was observed by a great scientist, Sir Isaac Newton. He has called this law as law of action reaction. And what is the statement of this law?
For every action,
there is an equal action. And opposite reaction.
Look here. To every action, there is a reaction. And this reaction will be the opposite direction and the magnitude will be same. And you can state this third law of motion as to every action, there is an equal and
opposite reaction.
To every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Please do remember that. If I take two objects, one is A and another one is B. When they collide with each other, A will exert the force on B. I call this as action force or reaction force?
Action force.
I'll represent action force as FAB. Means the force exerted by A on B. Even B will also exert force on A. How do you write that?
Reaction.
The force exerted by the second object on first object.
First object.
Both are equal in magnitude. Andre, you know, on the 10 Newton force on apply my code, then even the B object will also exert the same force, that is 10 Newton. Then I'll write minus. Then could I write 10 Newton is equal to minus 10 Newton?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is it possible to write or not?
Yes, sir.
If you think mathematically, whether it is right or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Mathematically wrong.
Mathematically. Can
you
be equal to minus 2?
Wrong, sir. No, sir.
Wrong.
But when you think scientifically,
it's correct.
Sir, because it has the same magnitude. Because it depends.
This has 10 Newton equal to minus 10 Newton. 10 Newton is always 10 Newton only. But here, the minus indicates it is
opposite direction.
Negative.
The force which is acting opposite to the direction of
action.
Direction in which force exerted by the first object. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Minus sign indicates a reaction force. Just remember like that.
Okay.
Now,
Sir,
let us take now, we will discuss more about Newton's third law of motion. Yeah, please write. Side A. Newton's third law of motion. This is third one. Newton's third law of motion. Newton's third law of motion. What it is also called? Law of
action
and reaction.
Right. Law of action. Put hyphen. Then write. Reaction. Law of action, reaction. Write out the statement. It states that, put comma, and start with inverted comma. Right, it states that to every action, put comma, there is
equal and opposite
reaction. To every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Close with inverted comma. Now let us go for writing this mathematically. As before that, just I draw a figure. Here I am taking the object, two objects. One is A and another one is object B. As they collide with each other, yes, you must. As they collide with each other, we can come to know that it is due to the force exerted by A or B. I'll call it as FAB. And the force exerted by B on A, it
is FBA.
A. Quickly, please go on writing with me. And this can be written as FAB. It is equal to negative FBA. Highlight this. It's a box. Hold on. Next, just below that, you write note. In this case, you can observe, as both the bodies are moving towards right direction. First, we'll consider the force exerted by A on B as action. Then we consider the force exerted by B on A as reaction. Okay. If you consider from here, suppose both the bodies are moving by left side, which will be the action force? Force exerted by B on A, that will be action force. And then force exerted by A on B, that will be
reaction force.
Right now, first, yaw the force on act madutho, that is action force. And even sometimes you'll observe that in athletics, when the athletes are moving in the same track with a different speed, then one will collide with the other. What? You know? Right. Here, action force. What is this?
Action force exerted by first object on second.
Exerted by first body on second body. You know, what is this anta kelidru go read this anta read this andre sir this is action what is this you have to tell it's definition right on it is a force exerted by first body on second body next what are you doing go and copy it with me second reaction force right it is the force exerted by second body or second object second body on first body or up I'll give you two more examples you just identify which of these two belongs to Newton's third law in that one is assume that a person is swimming in the pool does it belong to Newton's third law
yes sir
yes sir
yes sir, yes, sir.
Of course how do you say that it belongs to Newton's third law
keep pushes of water backside
yes very good when he is swimming you know that he will go for pushing the water right forward or backward
pushes
the water backward and they start moving
forward
right next similarly a sailor he jumps from the boat and jumping from the boat whether he pushes the boat or he pushes the boat or not
yes sir
yes sir
when he needs to then he push then he will go for jumping now could you tell which is the action force in this case
now pushing of the legs is action force
yeah the force exerted by that sailor on the boat that is by pushing it with his leg so that is action force and jumping forward
is reaction
and another thing yes what is this
rifle
pistol then
shotgun
shotgun
submachine gun
here is bullet the muzzle of the pistol when the trigger is pressed what happens
it recoils
bullet is fired sir
it gets fired bullet gets fired means it bullet comes from the muzzle of the pistol so it moves forward the bullet moves forward
action
at the same time even the pistol recoils
backward
pistol recoils then here the force with which the bullet moves forward
action force.
The forward movement of the bullet is action force
reaction
and there is also technique in using either rifle or pistol right even gun
reloading sir
yeah when we are firing then we'll take the support of our shoulder because to avoid the recoil of the gun or to fix the target properly
yes
but nowadays you might have known that some idiots they do not know how to use that gun or rifle simply they'll be moving towards the public and they'll go for firing. Who are those idiots?
Taliban.
Make the people to scare. It is very ironic thing to hear and to see also. The world should take care of them, but that is not going on. They are only experience and suffering. Okay, let it be. Now just come across this concept. So just we have taken few examples for action and reaction forces with illustration, that is with figures. Now I'll give you the situation. You just go for writing the action force and reaction. Right, side heading. Identify action force. What you are searching? Action force and reaction force. Just I'll give you only two examples. Right. A bullet is fired from the gun.
Firing is
force on bullet.
Forward movement.
Action
bullet is the action.
Here one student asking the doubt, first time clarity. No. It will be lane out from there. How sorry? In this figure, A is exerting the force on B. In which direction? Towards my right direction. This is AB. And the force exerted by B on A, it is on the left side. So that's why I have written B. Got it? And here, force exerted by A on B, then B on A. Yes. In this, which is the action force?
The bullet
force on bullet.
Force of bullet.
Force of bullet.
In forward direction.
The forward movement of the bullet is action
force.
Action reaction.
Which is the reaction?
Recoil.
The backward direction is the action force.
Action is forward movement of the bullet. Forward movement of the bullet. Next. Reaction is recoiling of the gun. Next. Another one. These two were given in the examination as well. One is bullet fired from the gun. Then second one is launching of rocket. Right. Launching of rocket. Which is action?
Force exerted by the gas.
Exerted on rocket in forward direction. Action.
Forward movement of the exhaust gas, that is, gas which were burned, it will be towards the rock.
Yeah.
Right. Action. Right. Downward movement of the exhaust gas. Reaction.
Upward movement of the rocket.
Upward movement or ascending of rocket. Upward movement of rocket. Over.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay, right. Over. Yes, students, you are very familiar with the concept called the quantity of motion possessed by a body. What is that?
Momentum.
Just to, for the sake of understanding, I am giving you some examples. You have to tell in which of these momentum will be more. I give some games name. One is cricket. Second one is hockey. Third one, football.
Football, sir.
Which one?
Hockey, sir. Hockey.
How many of you are telling that cricket?
No one.
Why? Because it is one of the passive game.
Sir, right? Less momentum, of course.
Active game. Ball active is there, Appa. Simply they'll be standing. When the ball comes, then they'll catch.
The right tail.
Okay. Listen.
Right tail, sir.
Let us not comment on any games. Just simply I'm giving the example only. On comparing cricket, hockey, and football, hockey, it has more momentum. Do you know why?
They keep on moving.
Along with the running, they'll also carry the stick. ಅದೊಂದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ವೆಯ್ಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಕಂಪರೇಟಿವ್ಲಿ ದ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಾಕಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ ದಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಟು ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್
ಬಿಕಾಸ್
ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಲೀಪಿಂಗ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಬಾಲ್ ಗೋಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಪ್ಲೇಯರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವಾಚಿಂಗ್ how he is going to catch or stop that. Dear students, regarding momentum only, I'll go for explaining the next concept. Hockey, I told hockey. Football is also good, almost equal to that. Good come. Is it? And before going to that concept, just let me make you to recall one of the familiar concept to you. What do you call the capability of doing work?
Work done.
Is energy. Capability of doing work is called energy. Our capacity to do work is called energy. We have different forms of energy, right? Like light energy, sound energy, thermal energy, heat energy, solar energy,
nuclear energy,
mechanical
energy.
Different forms are there. Can we convert one form of energy into another form?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If so, now, could you tell the energy conversion that takes place? Energy conversion that takes place in this electrical equipment.
Bulb.
Yes.
Sir, electric energy into light energy.
Heat into light energy.
This is the energy conversion takes place in electric bulb. Do you see? Ritika, look here. Next, another one. When you observe the running of the running fan, you'll come to know that first we'll switch on, right? Could you tell the energy conversion takes place in the running fan?
Energy to wind energy.
Electric to wind energy.
Into wind energy.
Electric energy to wind energy. Into wind energy.
Wind energy.
Electric energy.
One. Movement of the fan. Aduna now mechanical energy. Then when we switch on, electricity will start working. So electrical energy into mechanical energy. See, here in this way. One form of energy is being converted into another form. During the conversion, whether energy is wasted? No. Total energy is conserved. What do you call the law with respect to conservation of energy?
Law of conservation of momentum.
Law of conservation of energy. Then could you tell what is its statement? Energy can either be created nor destroyed, but it can be converted from one form to another form, right?
Yes.
Energy can either be created nor destroyed, but it can be converted from one form to other form. This is the law of conservation of energy. Even we have a law with respect to momentum as well, which is called the law of conservation of momentum. Law of conservation of momentum. Then obviously we have to recall the momentum concept. Okay. Yes, sir. No. It is next one. Look at them. It is a straight road. I'm going to take two objects. One is object of mass M1, and I call that object as A. And another one is also object mass M2. It may be more than that or less than that. It is B. Both are moving with the same velocity in the same direction, in the same path. Here I call it as U1, and this is U2. Now, could you tell what is the momentum of first body?
M1, M1.
Momentum of A.
M1, U1.
Momentum of B.
M1, U2.
U2.
Moving with the velocity. So, therefore, its momentum can be written as M2, U2. Could you tell the plural of momentum?
Momenta.
Momenta.
Yeah, it is momenta. Momenta. Look here. Now, how do you write momenta of these two bodies?
M1 U1 is equal to M2.
Momenta.
Less.
The sum of momenta of these two bodies is M1 U1 plus M2 U1. Right. Now let us assume that U1 is greater than U2. That is, velocity of first body is more than that of the second body. What happens after some time?
Collision takes
place. Yes, collide with each other. The collision takes place. Right? Yes. Here, both the bodies are moving in the same path, in the same direction. And they are having different velocities. We are assuming that velocity of first body is more than the second body. If they move continuously after some time, they crash. But then, they collide. Okay, let us go for the thing. Okay, wait. Okay, they collide with each other. But it's done. So now, can you take this as a collision is taking place? That is during. This is the situation during collision, right?
Yes, sir.
And this is
before collision.
Wait. Now, when they collide with each other, we all know that A will exert force on B. Will the B exert force on A?
Yes, sir.
Then, due to that, whether speed changes or not.
Yes, sir.
Observe. Wait. After collision, both they start moving with a different speed. I take the speed of first body as
V1.
So U1 is the collision happening, the speed change I do. It may increase or decrease, that is secondary. But the speed changes. I take this as V1. And velocity with which second body moves after the collision, it is
V2.
So
this is the situation. After
collision.
Collision. Then you go for finding the momentum of both. Yes, what is the momentum of first body after collision?
M1 V1.
Momentum of second body.
M2 V2.
Then the sum of momentum of these two bodies after collision. Dhanush.
M1 V1 plus M2 V2.
Then after finding this momenta, that is M1 V1, M2 V2, then when you find these two statements and compare, on comparing you come to know that both will be equal. Could you tell what does left hand side indicate?
Initial momentum.
Momentum before collision.
What? See that? The sum of momentum before collision. Of two bodies before collision, right? And this is the sum of momentum
after
of
collision. Two bodies after collision.
Then both will be equal to one another. If no external unbalanced force is acting, the matter bare vehicle, bare object one going to collide one, that is different. Got it? So, and then, even at the no. Different it will be. Now, this is what we say, the law of conservation of momentum. Understanding, listen up. How do you say that? It depends on the direction in which they'll be moving. Look here. Once I tell the state of law of conservation of momentum, please recall with me. Don't write anything. Law of conservation of momentum states that the sum of momenta of two bodies before collision is equal to the sum of momenta of two bodies after the collision, provided there is no external unbalanced force acting on them. Yavadu matte extra force yavadu illa antandre avaga ಇವೆರಡೂ ಕೂಡ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್? ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯೂಶುವಲಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ದ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೊಮೆಂಟಮ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿರೈವ್ ದ ಲಾ ಆಫ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೊಮೆಂಟಮ್. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡಿರೈವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನ್ಯೂಮರಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್. ನಿಮಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಐದರ್ ಯುಲ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಡಿರೈವೇಶನ್ ಆರ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಮರಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಎವ್ರಿ ನೀವು ವೆನ್ ಯು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಪೇಪರ್ಸ್ ಯುಲ್ ಬಿ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಐದರ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿರೈವೇಶನ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ನ್ಯೂಮರಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್. ವೆದರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್? If it is over, or if you have read the textbook, you will come to know three important situations with respect to law of conservation of momentum. One is, bullet is fired from the gun. We'll solve the problems on bullet, the concept, law of conservation of momentum with respect to this situation. Second situation, hockey players, when they'll be moving, either they may come in the opposite direction or one may be running behind the other player. They'll be entangled, right? Because they collide with each other. That is it, that situation. And third one is, in that they have given, a girl will jump on the cart wheel. And after jumping on the wheel, both will move together. These are the three important statements or numerical problems with respect to law of conservation of momentum. Almost examiner, one will be given among these three. Or else, then ask you the derivation. How to derive? So before derivation, you go for writing the statement of law of conservation of momentum. Dhanush, where are you? Right. Thank you. Law of conservation of momentum. Please put 3-star mark for this. Law of conservation of momentum. It is to be derived based on Newton's law. I'll tell you how this, right? Law of conservation of momentum. Law of conservation of momentum. Anybody want to tell the statement?
The sum of the momentum before collision is equal to momentum after collision if no external unbalanced force is applied on.
Yes, right. If no external force will be acting on the bodies, then the sum of the momentum of bodies before collision is equal to after collision. Right. The sum of momentum of two bodies before collision is equal to the sum of momentum of two bodies after collision, provided there is no external unbalanced force acting on them. Close with inverted commas. Provided there is no external unbalanced force acting on them. Just let us write the mathematical expression for this. What it is? If I consider the masses of two bodies as m1 and m2, their initial velocities as u1 and u2, and final velocities as v1 and v2, then we can write it as
m1, u1, m2, u2,
m2, u2. M2 U2
is equal to
M1 V1 plus M2 V2.
M2 V. I'll write that in the box. Now, we are going to derive this equation. Question example, you have to clear your theory. Derive the law of conservation of momentum using Newton's third law of motion. Write the same thing. Right. Next. Derive. Derive the law of conservation of momentum using Newton's third law of motion. Derive the law of conservation of momentum conservation of momentum using Newton's third law of motion. Here we need two bodies before collision as well as after collision situations. Yes, let's go for two items now. Now, conservation of momentum using Newton's third law of motion.
That is not written. That is not.
Good enough. Draw a straight line. Is the one writing with me? Let me go for taking the objects. The size of the objects may be equal or different. I take first one as A, second one as B, its mass as M1. B, its mass is M. They move with the different speeds, you write them as U1, U2. During collision, draw it. It is again A and B. The force exerted by A and B and B on A can be shown. It is F A B. This is FBA. Next, after collision, both bodies A and B, M1 and M2, but their velocities will be changed. This V1 and V2.
Sir, after some time, they may stop, no, sir?
Yeah, of course. Just we are taking the situation, two situations, just before collision and after collision. Here you write. Before collision, this is during collision, and this is after collision. Ora, that's finished. Stop right now. First, observe. Let me explain the derivation. Afterwards, again, you can write with. Now, your concentration should be completely here. Nalpate, stop writing. Look at them. They ask you to derive the law of conservation of momentum using Newton's third law of motion. To derive the law of conservation of momentum, you must know momentum of both the bodies before collision as well as after collision. Then, what is it? Momentum of body A before collision.
M1 U1.
Second body?
M2 U2.
Next, after some time, the velocity changes. We have mentioned that. Let's go. They collide with each other. Now, let's go for five, taking their momentum after collision. First body.
M1, V1.
They ask you to use Newton's third law of motion. Lakshmi Shri, what is that Newton's third law of motion? It is.
To every action,
there is an equal
definition or name.
There is an equal and opposite reaction. How do you express that mathematically?
F1 = -F2.
F1 = -F2.
Objects as A and B at the third order. I'm writing like this. But do you know the force? How do you come to know the force? According to Newton's second law of motion,
force is equal to m into a.
Mass into acceleration.
The rate of change of momentum of a body is directly proportional to
applied unbalanced force.
We have to find out the rate of change of momentum of both the bodies.
MD minus MD.
Rate of change of momentum of body A.
M1 U1.
Wait. What is the momentum of body A before collision?
M1 U1.
After collision?
M1 V1.
What is the change in momentum?
M1 V1 minus M1 U1.
Sir, what is rate of change of momentum of body A?
M1 U1 minus M1 V1.
Momentum of second body, that is body B, before collision. This is
M2 U2 minus.
Wait. Changing momentum of body B. M2 V2 minus M2 U2. Rate of change of momentum can be
M2 V2 minus M2 U2 by B.
Both are equal and opposite in direction. So can be written like this. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Now P and P get cancelled. Next, it is M1 V1 minus M1 U1 is equal. What is by minus?
minus
minus plus
m2 v2 plus
m2 plus m2 u2
u2
then m1 v1 transfer this
minus m2
plus
m2 v2
m2 u2 transfer this
plus m1 u1
m1 u1 rearrange it as let's just
m1 u1 m1 u1 plus m2 u2
is equal to
m1 v1 plus m2
v1 plus m2
v2 m2 v2 hence this derived. Is it not simple?
Yes,
yes sir.
No, simple is enough. Very simple. Newton's third law used, what is it? Given we have also used Newton's second law. Second law, the rate of change of momentum of the body. Artha itara. Now let's move on to actual steps. Right. Consider what we have considered position.
Mass of A as m1.
We have considered two of bodies. One is A and another one is B. With their masses as m1 and m2.
M2 respectively.
Respectively. Wait, wait. Start writing. Let A and B be the two bodies of masses m1 and m2 respectively. And the other body, or else that m1 and m2 be the masses of A and B respectively. What? Then, what do you say about u1 and u2?
Initial velocity
and final velocity.
Initial velocity of B, right? U1 and U2 are the initial velocities. Initial velocities next. What is t? Time for what?
Time taken.
Collision.
Which body gets collided? Right. T is the time after which A and B collide. Next. Collide or minute, their velocity changed. I write it as V1 and V2 are the final velocities for a output implies simple. Now we are going to find out the momentum of both the bodies before collision as well as after collision. Right. First case. Before collision. Yes. What are you searching? Sachit, why? Can't you see? Can't you see? Until no one tell up. Right. Before collision, momentum of A, just tell me. Here
M1 U1.
Next. Momentum of B.
M2 U2.
M2 U2. Next. After collision. Write with me. After collision. Don't be lagging. Please go on writing with me. After collision. What is the momentum of A?
M1 V1.
M1 V1. Next. Momentum of B.
M2 V2.
V2. Next. We have to find out. We have to write the rate of change of momentum of A. Yes, what are you writing? I think still you are here. So now we'll be tight. Have you copied up here?
Yes, sir.
Meka, Chandana, Kyar, Amit, Chetan, Siddesh, Kulambi, Nalpet. Yes, still you are writing there. Rachit, where are you now? Okay, Daksh. Daksh. After correction. Here, Tejasvi CP. Return. MY. MY. Okay, good. Shreya D. Giridhar. Yes, okay. Bhumika L. Jaknur. Niharika. Sanjita. Manya A. Mohita. Aniket. Kanasapler. Garo S. Hardy. Tanmay. Sanvi. Sinchanavi Patel. Aditya Praveen Anvekar is ready. Very good boy. Very good boy. Samarth. Ritika. Yes, all of you are written. Very good. Now. Yes. Over. Because you are voting like this and writing. When you are writing, your both hands should be on the desk. Then energy will be circulating. Even your computer, energy goes here and here also. Current will not pass. Okay, very good. Circuit close agidre matra, energy current will be passing. It's the same way. Your both hands should be there on the table. Then energy will be circulating correctly. Very clever. Next. It is rate of change of momentum of A. What it is?
M1 minus M1 U1 by T.
By T.
T.
It is nothing but the force exerted by A on B. We can write FAB. FAB equal to M1 V1 minus M1 U1 by T. According to what? Really? On what basis we have written it?
Third law of motion.
Second law of motion.
Very good. Newton's.
Second law.
Second law of motion. Next. Right. Rate of change of momentum of B. It is equal. Siddesh, tell how to write rate of change of momentum of B. M2 V2 minus M2 U2 by T. It is nothing but it is force exerted by B on A. It is equal to M2 V2 minus M2 U2 by T On what basis you have written this? Again.
Second law.
Newton's second law of motion. We have got the force exerted by first body on B, second body, as well as second body on first body. Then how to write the relationship between these two?
According to third
FAB is equal to minus FAB.
FAB equal to minus FBA. According to
third law.
Right here. According to Newton's. Newton's third law of motion. According to Newton's third law of motion, how do you write? FAB equal to minus
FB.
Where FAB can be written as today M1 B1. Don't write like this M1 B1 invariably. It should be prefix for, sorry, subscript, subscript
for subscript.
M1 V1 minus M1 U1 by T minus, right, M2 V2 minus M2 U2 by T. Now T and T get cancelled. Right, it is M1 V1 minus M2 U2, it is equal, start multiplying by minus 3. It is minus M2 V2, here minus into minus plus M2 U2. Now rearrange the terms. On rearranging, we can write yes. M1 U1, when you write it under positive one, it is M1 U1 plus M2 V2. It is already on the right hand side. M2 U2. It's equal to, next. It is on the left side. M1 V1. Transfer this to the left hand side. Plus M2 V2. Then below this, you write. Hence, the law of conservation of momentum is derived. Is the law of conservation of momentum. You want, you can discuss with me, even in your school also, it may be over and see the steps. If any clarification you want, you can discuss with me. So for discussion, I've given you the timing in the evening from 6 to 8 o'clock. Meanwhile, I'll give you one information regarding science test. Today it is not possible to conduct. So I had already given you the information in the message. I'll observe your school timings today and tomorrow. Based on that, I'll conduct science test. It is on Wednesday. Science test will be on Wednesday, and timing will be given in the group one. Okay. And tomorrow, we are moving to solve the problem for this. Probably this chapter will be completed by tomorrow. With this, let us stop the class. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.